He hung there on the cross, and he did that for me.
Amen.
Huh? You all may not know nothing about it. You can sit there quiet, but he did it for me.
Amen.
His life saved my life. And for that, I said, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Huh? All praises to my Father in heaven and to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to Pastor Wilson and the company ministers. Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Easter day.
Happy
and a holy Easter day.
Amen.
And I am so grateful to come with you all once again to share with you just a word. Just wanted to show you that clip because I'm going to come back and ask you some questions in a minute. Hope you are paying attention.
All right.
So if you would now, just go with me with as I pray for a brief moment, and then I'm going to come back with a message for you. Is that all right?
All right.
Gracious Father, Lord, we come now, Lord. We thank you, Father, for this day. We thank you for Jesus, God, that he hung, bled, and died, but only that he rose, Father God, and that we serve a risen Savior. Father God, as you fill me now with your spirit, that they see less of me and more of thee. In the mighty name of Jesus, I do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Romans 5. Verse 8. It says, but God commended his love towards us,
yes,
in that while we were yet sinners,
yeah,
Christ died,
yes,
for us.
Yeah.
And I want to talk to you briefly this morning about a price that's already paid.
All right.
A price,
yes,
already paid.
Yeah.
The world at times offers us some free gifts. Sometimes we get free trip to Las Vegas. We may get free tickets to the ball game, free tickets to concerts or cruise. And when you go pick up the gift, you don't have to pay anything. Huh? All you have to do is go up there and accept it. Don't have to pay nothing. And then they show on the TV sometimes, they offer, you know, we have free cancer screenings, and they give away free food and give away free school supplies, huh? Free housing, and then when you see on TV, it's a long line. People everywhere running to get the free gift. Don't have to pay nothing, already paid now. Don't have to leave no down payment. Don't have to put it on layaway. Just go and accept the gift. Now, God also offers a free gift. But you don't see anybody in line.
All right.
Trying to hurry up for his gift. Nobody is in a hurry to take advantage. It's free. Don't have to pay nothing. Don't have to put nothing down on it. But yet no one is in line. Why is it then that some are so reluctant to accept God's free gift? You see, man rejects God's gift because mankind has a love for darkness instead of the light. You see, the closer a person comes to the light of the gospel, G-O-S-P-E-L, God's only son, purchasing eternal life. When they get closer to that, you see, sinfulness is exposed. And some people enjoy living a sinful life. They don't want to give it up.
Right.
They think it's fun.
Yeah.
I don't understand that. I did not know a joy until I accepted Jesus Christ. And I like living this kind of life. It's a blessed life. So I don't understand this when they say, when they don't want to accept Jesus. This leads me to believe then that they do not fully understand the offering of God's gift. For when I go out with witnesses, I hear some people say, I'm not ready yet. When I stop doing this, then I will accept the Lord. I wait and get myself right. Or I wait and get myself straight. You cannot get yourself right. You cannot get yourself straight. That's what Jesus does. And we have eternal life through acceptance and faith in him. And the price is already paid. Now your point of meditation. I got it made because it's already paid. Let me hear y'all say, I got it made. Because
it's already paid.
All right, let's see now. Let's see. How did it pay? Romans 5, verse 8. But God, listen, y'all, commended his love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God, our heavenly Father, Jehovah God, Almighty God, commended. That means he demonstrated his love towards us. shows giving clear evidence, confirmed without a reasonable doubt, that he loved us.
Yes.
Now, y'all, it says while we were yet sinners.
Yeah.
That means we were sinning when he died.
Yeah.
Huh? I have come across, they stopped doing something. Huh? Said while we were yet sinners. You see, in the beginning, God and man were in harmony with one another. And then Adam's sin disobeyed God. That caused then a separation from God. And all of Adam's descendants then are under sentence of death and penalty of sin. Hmm? And that Romans 3:23 says what? For all have sinned. Huh? Did it say y'all have sinned? What it said? All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So then sin separates God from us. And so what that did, that created a gulf between man and God.
Yeah.
Huh? Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is death. Come up here and help me, Brother Anderson. The wages of sin is death. Wages, then, that means cost something. Wages, that's the price. So man and God, hand in hand, harmony together. Sin separates the two. Now God is way over there. And man is way over here. So God says, how is it then that I'm going to get man back to myself? And so what he does then, he makes a way for man to get across. Got it? He makes a way. Thank you, brother. For man to get across.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Let's see then how he does this. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever will believes in him, what's going to happen? Shall not perish, but you will have everlasting life. Now, this is the clearest declaration anywhere that salvation is free. And I got it made because it's already what?
Paid.
It's already paid. And God, he sent his only son, Jesus, who came down in human form to rescue us. Did you not know that nobody could do this but Jesus?
Yeah.
I don't get it twisted. Mary did not save you. Peter did not save. Jesus did this. Did you not know that Jesus came down so that we could go up?
Yeah.
There's no greater love than this. Did you not know that Jesus' love for you is greater than your faults?
Yeah.
When you find somebody that'll love you greater than your faults, you better hold on to them.
Yeah.
Huh? Love us. His love, his love, his love.
Yes.
Lay down his life for his friend. Yeah. Unconditional love.
Yeah.
Love us in spite of. Did you see on the video when they beat him beyond recognition? 39 lashes. He did it for me. Did you see the crown of thorns on his head? Did you see the nail prints? He has a nail print in his hand. The devil tried to cut the video off, but he has a nail print in his hand. They thought them nails were going to keep him on the cross, but that nail was not for him, though nail was for us. Nailing down our sin, nailing down our lies, nailing down our adultery, nailing down our fornication. Huh? Love! Ah! Help him on the cross. Love, 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 love! What can wash away my sin? Nothing, nothing, nothing but the blood of Jesus. And you know what, y'all? It's paid in full. Did y'all see that on there? Say paid in full. Don't even have to leave no tip. Huh? T-I-P. Total M-K. And I got it made. Because it's already paid. Now, some among us who still may not understand, so I'm going to break it down for you a little further, and then I'm going to sit down. Because Pastor's going to deliver the word. And when he gets through, he's going to offer an invitation. He's going to go something like this. Romans 10:9 says, y'all listen, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, listen, believe in your heart, God has raised him from the dead, you shall be what?
Saved.
And then it goes down to verse number 13. It says, whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever. Who? You. Who don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sin. Who? You. Who are sitting there gazing at me pretending like you know. Who? You. Who are in desperate need of a Savior. Whosoever. You see that soul, that's unconditioned. When you see it, say, God, so love the word.
Yeah.
Whosoever. You may say, well, I'm a murderer. Jesus say, so. I cheat. He say, so. I sell drugs. So. I lied on somebody. So. I'm on crack. So. That's why you need Jesus. You will come to realize that crack ain't what got you messed up. It's the crack in your life without Jesus. So. He says, who so? Help.
I like that.
So. Some people say I'm born a homosexual. So. That's why we all got to be born again. I got it, mate. They're talking crazy. You can't get yourself. Come out, honey. He does the straightening out. Now, you have to truly believe this. He knows when you're playing. Because when you come in contact with Jesus, your life will no longer be the same. 2 Corinthians 5 and 17 says, if any man be in Christ, what happens? He a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things become new.
Yeah.
You see, he can restore you. He makes a change, Brother Appleberry. Huh? He'll turn your mess into a message. Your misery into ministry. He gives deliverance to the drug addict. Praise to the prostitute. Hallelujah to the homosexual. Holiness to the hoochie. He gives righteousness for the riffraff. He'll turn your trash. Good. But once you become saved, don't you still sin? Yes. But God got something for that too.
Yeah.
You see, now when you come into Christ, you no longer are under the penalty of sin, nor the power of sin.
Yeah.
And ultimately, you're going to be saved from the presence then of sin.
Yeah.
John 1 John 1 and 9 says, if we confess our sin, what? He is faithful and he's just to forgive us our sins. And cleanse us from all unrighteousness. See that when you accept Christ, listen at this, y'all. Then there ain't no reason. Why would you want to turn around and deal with hell up here and turn around and die and go to hell? That does not make any sense whatsoever. God is offering you eternal life. Huh? So when you accept Christ, you get a double life. You get a new life here on earth. And then you get to spend eternity with him. He allows then the Holy Spirit to indwell in us while we're here to sustain us and keep us here. Huh? And then when you get to heaven, you get to spend wonderful time with him. All right, now ask Brother Trey to come up here and help me. I'm going to show y'all a little bit of this and I'm going to sit down. Now, he's going to be my cross. Let me explain something to you. There's two sides to this cross. On this side is earth where we is now. This is where we are. On this side. This is where man, this is earth. If you see me, you on this side. Now over here, that's where Jesus is. Huh? All right. Now you don't take yourself over there. Huh? Say never lie. God calls you over here. And until he calls you over there, he sustains you here.
Yeah.
And so while I'm here, I'm looking forward then to being with Jesus over there. You see, on this side, I have to pay some bills. When I get over here, I don't have to pay no more bills. on this side, I may have to cry sometime. When I get over here, he gonna wipe my tears away. Pastor say he gonna stop things from happening where I won't have to cry. But on this side, how my knees hurt me sometime. Some of us are in walkers and we got cane and all wheelchair, but when we get over here, walk around heaven all day on this side. Our loved one might be gone. My daddy is gone. I can't do nothing but look at the picture of him. But when I get over here, I'm going to say, hey, Jay. Hey, Sister Nee. Hey, Whitney. Hey, Reverend John. When I get over on this side, oh, I got to bear a cross. When I get over here, I'm gonna wear me a crown. Yeah. On this side. Oh, I can only just know the spirituality of Jesus. When I get over here, I'm going to behold his face. And when I see Jesus, I may. When I see Jesus, the one who died for me. CT, yeah. I got it made. Cause it already paid.
Amen.
You ought to give God some praise in this house. Isn't he worthy? Let's give some.